Recording so that I was touching the button for this. Yeah. I think you want to see the recording clip. So employability is becoming a big question for parents, big question for school teacher or institution, and most important, it's a big question for the youth of any country. So as PIE India start with the vision that we have to produce and develop the program which is truly employable, then question comes how we can make it employable. In 2010 to 2015 we are continue working on the developing the syllabus, and more than 84 subject we covered, and finally the 5-year journey in India we got the copyright from Ministry of HRD, because education comes under umbrella of Ministry of HRD. Then question comes again ki now what we can do for the employability. So for that we have a member, core member of Indian Exhibition Services, which is associated with the ITPO Pragati Maidan. Then they finally make us a 8 core member for India to organize the Asia Sports Fair. This national sports fair, then next year Asia, and now it is going on the international sports fair. So we 8 members started in 2015 to organize a sports fair, which is the first time in India. Then second and third year MSME and ITPO, they come with us, and more important that the Sports Goods Manufacturing Association, the president Mr. Puneet Mohan Sharma, he also shaken with Sports Academy Association of India. Yes, boys, you are doing a good job, all teachers, all principals. Then we have to provide the employability to your certificate pass out students. So make it line employable, economical, educational programs for India. And here we have a 2 speaker with us, Mr. Lakhveer Singh ji. He's the head of group operations, UK Allied Sports Group, London, UK. And here UK is not a Uttarakhand, it's a United Kingdom, which is I need to be clear to everyone, because in Uttarakhand we also told that yeah, we are living in the UK. And another very sparkle lady with us, Mr. Kaur. She's a principal of SBASS school. If you read in the running, it's called Shabash. So SBASS, Shabash school from Ludhiana. And definitely she, so many times she told me ki Dr. Arora, we in Ludhiana, in Jalandhar, there's a plenty of people, those want to make their career in a sports. And she counseled more than 500 I think privileged girls. Those are from the economical weaker section, and her heart is very soft. She always talk me, can we help those? Can we help? Yes, you can do whatever you want to do. So she, as with his face, and she is also very beautiful with her heart. So again, namaskaram to both of my speaker and grand welcome. So, let us, as per universal norms, we can start the ladies first, but since a sparkle ladies first, so I invite to Ms. Ravinder Kaur for the welcome note. So welcome, Ms. Ravinder Kaur.
Thank you, Devinder. I think you are just making me somewhere embarrassed also, but it's the one of the true thing that I always felt, and I always now and then I had discussed with you. As being the principal of, earlier, no doubt I have served in the private institutions. But right now I am working in one of the school, that is Satya Bharati, where we are all children are underprivileged. In our Satya Bharati school, we are not charging a single penny from the kids. Everything is supposed to be provided free, even the uniform, books, and I will say, and even they are not supposed to buy a single pen from market also. So what I say, feel ki, when I have supposed to discuss with Devinder, that I have seen that in villages also in the rural area, they are not getting that, I will say, the career oriented places, or because they are very good in sports. If I will talk about my Ludhiana Sahodya, in a year, mine school win near about 14, I will say 432 medals. And the positions. And the moment the students are in the ground or in the, I will say, the platform, that they will say, "Ah, Gya Satya Bharti School," they will take the trophy, they will take the medals. And my office is full of that. I will just send the share the pics also those. But somewhere I felt that I discussed with them that the students, they are very good in academics. I have 1,418 students. And main, we are giving the preference to the girls first. But what happened, well, they are not getting that, I will say, the places where they can show their talent. For that, but in the sports, they are having the very good stamina, I will say, on the other part. And I always requested him, just let me know what to be done for these girls, these boys. Because somewhere that time has gone when the child in their mind have that we want to be a doctor, we want to be an engineer. That's it. But now it is not the one. They want to adapt to something new. And this pandemic, I will say, the crisis is reminding also the one in the same. And I feel that somewhere we should be very proud in India that many sportsmen like Milkha Singh, we will say, P.T. Usha, they are supposed to be the one of the gold medalists in Olympic and in, I will say, in India. Secondly, the grand events like Asian Games, cricket, hockey, and many more. They attract those guys. And that is the one. And secondly, I feel that if they will get the opportunity, definitely they will be the at the top most. Because they have that caliber. They have that, I will say, the zeal to win or to main is that participation. Because whenever we are supposed to ask the students, we used to say, participation is more important, whether you lose or win. So the same over there, there is in their mind, we want the very good, I would say, the platform. And this is the one only, as in CBSE also, we are supposed to go for that Khelo India and all. There, the winner is also with the one of the main, I would say, the member of that. And always the CBSE director and all are supposed to say, ki bhi, haan, dekho, wo, itna jyada devoted, itna kuch bachcho ke liye kar rahe hain. Then we should think of that also. And always he has been the part of those webinars and seminars. And there also we had come to know, that's why I feel we should give them the platform, and we are giving, and they are getting the chance also. It's the one of the time when we are supposed to go for the virtual teaching and learning. We are having the many, I will say, the clippings or with the videos had been shared by the vendor, so that I can make them also to be aware that yes, we can do this, and this way we can help the students. Thank you, Devinder. I have now asked Lakvi, yeah. Or yeah,
thank you, Devinder, very much you for the through. Welcome remark for the sports education and its importance in India. And truly our Indian youth are very energetic, they need an opportunity. So yeah. One thing I read somewhere there, what is the success? Then I told, when talent meet with opportunity. So talent should meet with opportunity, then he can choose his merits and definitely he will get. And today, from last 5 years, we are creating an opportunity for the people, and those are talented, they come forward and we will provide them this platform. Then after their end of their career in a green ground, once they cross the age of 30 or 35, then they're searching blindly where to go. Because everybody wants to see the support from the government. It's just like a see a stars in a night. So don't see a stars. You have to take initiative. You have to do something for yourself. Even then, I have one of friend with me, Ms. Sunanda Jati, and Goldie Sehgal is with me. Then these people are like that. They sponsor the 1 kg milk to emerging players. 1 kg milk, the small contribution. I think 6 bananas, it's a small contribution, but it makes a big foundation. If each and everyone think on it, then definitely we able to make a sports environment in India. So now, for welcome remark, I wish to invite Lakbir Singh ji. So just say a few words for the sports education, then question answer session, and then Lakbir ji, you give the international glimpses of employability in sports. So over to Lakhvirji.
Thank you very much, Dr. Raji. Firstly, namaste, sasti kaal and adab. Good afternoon to colleagues and guests joining from the UK and Europe, and a very good evening to all of you joining from India and South Asia. It is a real pleasure and honor to be invited today to join this webinar, Global Employment Opportunity with Sports Management, Ludhiana to London. My name is Lakhbir Singh, and I am head of group operations here in the UK for the UK Elite Sports Group. I would like to place on record a special thanks to our esteemed host, Dr. Roraji, and the team at Spire India. Later on, I will be giving a presentation to provide insights into our organization and employment in the UK. But before I do that, I would like to give you a brief background about myself. I'm actually third generation born here in the UK. My grandfather came to UK from India in the late 1940s. His vision, mission was to come to the UK to promote education and business and entrepreneurship. So furthermore, to ensure that family members become good citizens and represent the motherland, namely India here in the UK. So my grassroots are in India and in particular in the north in Punjab. So as we progress today, I'll be sharing detailed insights going forward. And it's a great pleasure to be here, and I'll pass it back to Dr. G.
So thank you so much for the welcome remark. Hello, Deepak Rai, how are you? Deepak Rai, how are you, man? Yes. Hi, how are you? Yeah, so quite relaxed. Yeah, hi, Goldie, how are you? He's a Goldie Sehgal in our camera. You can see he use a mask in the, I think you are in a field, huh? Goldie, great. So let us over to Ravinder ji, then madam just told about the opportunity and how sports education or education with sports can cope up by the any can say admirable or who have a big ambition to make his career in a sports. But in India, our parent told just you have to educate first, then go to sports. So just enlighten us how sports and education can help them to shape up their career. Over to Ravinder ji.
Yeah. I feel that the relationship between sports and education is having the very good and the close relationship. Young people who develop sports skills feel more positive about their bodies and their physical abilities, and therefore their self-esteem also improves. We had gone through many researches that found that the youth who were involved in school sports had better scores on all three mental health assessments compared with those who did not play sports at all. Even I feel that it controls the mood swings also. Whenever in the, especially in the teenagers, if I will see the classes of the, especially 6 to 10th, I will say, if I will focus on those kids, if they are not having, they are the one when the number of, I will say the hormones are changed. They are not able to share anything with anyone. And they put their all exertion and all activities and all development or all, I will say, in the ground. And they are really playing very good. And efforts are supposed to be placed over there. It burns those cells that is supposed to be not to be over, I will say, required to change their hormonal changes. Secondly, what I want to say that in education, if the sports is there, it make them learn many skills as well as teamwork. That is most important. If next I will go for that, that is the one among the students nowadays, as few belong to the single family, single, I will say, and joint family. It depends. So but when they are supposed to be in the group, they learn from sports only that how to help, how to be the part, as well as how to build a teamwork, do the teamwork, and how to do something social and even for themselves. And education is if I will take nowadays yoga and meditation, it has been become the one of the most important part in my school virtual teaching and learning. Also, we are giving the 40 minutes separately for that. What I have seen after that period, they start, and even they used to, they ask me, ma'am, when we will have the indoor games, when we are back to our playground, so that we want to play over there, we want to play hockey, we are want to play every activity. But I try to make it out from there. It helps in education a lot, even in the social activity, mental ability, and even I will say the development, holistic development, it's a part of the holistic development also, the sports. So that is the part of education too. And for youth, it's nowadays, if we are supposed to say, they are rushing or going to the other side also, that is of the drugs and all. This is one of the best, I will say, the step to be taken and focus to be on the sports, so that their diversion or the mind setup will be changed accordingly. That's it. Thank you, Devinder.
Yeah, it's a really good enlightenment about for the sports education scope up with the sports. So now over to Lakbir ji, just says about the employment opportunity of sports in, I can't say only in London, it can be say in Europe. So from Ludhiana to London, just you know the entire thing, you know the culture, and you know the energy of youth. So over to you, Lakbir ji.
Okay, many thanks. Firstly, it was great to hear from Ravinder ji. And so thank you very much for sharing your thoughts and experience. Doctor, I'd just like to share my presentation.
Yeah, please.
So I will just do this now. Okay, so can you see, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes, we can.
Okay. Just give me a second. Right. Okay, so welcome to UK Elite Sports Group. And as I said earlier, delighted to be sharing insights around global employment. I thought I'd start off firstly, give you a background about the organization and what we do here in the UK. So we're one of the UK's most trusted providers of youth sports coaching, tours, and coach education. The group consists of four different companies, and we have over 25 years Pacific sports sector experience. We engage with, on average, 50,000 children per week. The different organizations, the different companies form part of the organization. And our flagship is Planet Education. Now, through Planet Education, we go into schools all around the south of England, and we support the schools in providing physical education services. Recently in January, and I'm sure you'd all agree, January now seems to be so far away, but in January, we came to India on our inaugural business delegation. We visited Delhi, Mumbai, and Coimbatore, during which we built relationships with various different key stakeholders to provide the various different services which we offer. Through our residential trips, global residential trips, we provide children and teachers who come along to visit iconic buildings, world-class stadiums all around the UK and in Europe. With cricket, we provide residentials, talent ID sessions, and stadium visits. As you can see, the iconic Lord's building here in the middle of the image. So for us, coach education and train the trainer is very important. So through this, We provide young people the access and experience for them to progress in the field of sports, whether it's the UK, Europe, or India. And as you can see here, CPD Masterclass Coaching is something that we are experts in. And to help children, students on their journey, we ensure and always offer relevant qualifications. In addition, to support the correct learning experience, we offer best user experience with transferable systems, which if you're conducting training or learning in any sports, you must have the right infrastructure to enable you to ensure you're learning in the correct way. Here are just some images about some of the work that we do with children here in the UK. Recently, we formed an official partnership with the ACS Cobham International School. Now, this school is 30 minutes from London, and it forms world-class facilities. And when we engage with teams that come from around the world to the UK, we provide them with the correct facilities. And as you can see in the image, the access we have is with elite leading masterclass coaches. And here is the current England head coach, Mr. Eddie Jones, who came along and facilitated a masterclass with us. For the past 10 years, we've been taking groups to Sweden to provide them with the exposure, the competitive reality with football. And as you can see, we're planning to promote and facilitate teams in India. So what happens here is teams that want to come from India to the UK, we provide them with relevant training, and then we take them, if they're ready, into Sweden. And what that does, as well as the player, the teachers that come along, or the students that come along who want to progress and who want to learn and achieve that experience, exposure, we provide them with that. To give you a quick overview of the 10 most popular sports in the United Kingdom, the first, as I'm sure you would imagine, is football. And as we discussed, football is one of the biggest sports around the world with around 3.3 billion fans worldwide. As you can see on number 8, we have snooker. And why snooker? It's a big sport here in the UK, but its origins were formed in India in Uti. So many, many years ago, snooker was formed in Uti. Now going on to employability. So if you look at this, if you look at the sport, someone is to mute their video. That's better. So going on to the sports ecosystem, so in terms of employability from sports, there are various different areas. Once you complete a sports management degree or any type of educational learning, the sports ecosystem offers various different areas that one can then progress onto. And as you can see from the slide, we have sponsorship, marketing, broadcasting. Now, as you know, in broadcasting, one of the biggest broadcasters in India is Star TV. So the educational angle is very key, but going forward, the sports ecosystem can provide various different platforms for one to progress. I'd just like to show you when we visited India at the beginning of the year, we came in association with the India Business Group. And as you can see here, there's an image of our CEO, Mr. Chris Vatanis, who was unable to be available today because it's their birthday. So I'd like to place on record a very happy birthday to Chris Vatanis. And Chris has been in the sports sector for over 2 decades and has trained and polished thousands of individuals who have completed their education come to our organization and have gone on to do bigger and better things. So finally, I would just like to say a thank you to everyone for listening to this brief presentation. And if you do have any questions, I'll be more than delighted to answer. Thank you very much.
Yeah, it's very nice to hear about the UK. And I just put up some question in the chat box. So anyone who come forward and then share their views. So here I wish to invite Sunanda Jati. Madam, are you here? Madam Sunanda Jati, your flavor is like Ravinder Korman. You always dedicated for your students and always number of time we talk for each other. Madam Sunanda Jati, might be she is not with us. Then we have Dr. Rama Matto with us. Welcome, Dr. Rama. I saw nowadays you are on the TV channels, become a good host and plenty of things. Just share your views with the words of Lakhveer Singh Ji and Ravindra Kaur Ji. Please.
Not audible.
We can't hear you, Rama.
Rama?
We can't hear you. Yes.
Hear me now?
Yeah.
No. Okay. So I was just saying thank you so much, Davinder Ji, for giving me such words. And thank you to Lakhvinder Ji, because the presentation he shared will be very beneficial for all the students. And whatever he discussed about the sports and education is equally good. And Ravinder, hi, how are you?
You? Fine.
So it was good seeing you here and listening to you. As usual, so educationists mostly share the same view. Education and sports, as I say, it's such a bond which can never be broken or which can never have a gap in between. That is how it goes. Not in school only, in colleges and universities as well. Having so much of significance. So, Lakhvinder Ji, actually, I would like to understand, because the system of sports is different at different places. So how do you suggest that the things can improve here in our country? And what are your suggestions for during these pandemic days? Because every child, every adult is, locked back in home. So outdoor games are 99% not possible for the people. Yes. So what is your suggestion for upgrading the sports, and what suggestions do you give to all? I will not ask for a particular age, I'll say for all.
Okay. So I think one thing is very clear is that the COVID-19 pandemic has affected everyone worldwide. So every country is dealing with the pandemic at different stages. So for example, here in the UK, we have passed the peak. So we are now shifting from survival to revival. So here things are slightly opening up. So the impact on sports and education and participation in the UK is slightly different to what it may be in India at the moment.
Hey.
But in terms of engagement, the only practical way is if it's possible to do things virtually. So during the beginning of the pandemic, what we did here as an organization is our Planet Education coaches, who are the teachers, they virtually created activities and they shared them via our social media platforms, no charge, to ensure that children are receiving as much physical education as they can, because as we all know, physical education boosts cognitive behavior and other mental health and various other issues. So
I'm sorry to interrupt. So my question here is, again, it is like we are giving doing these things, or it's all virtual that is happening. See, we as an education sector have already compromised with electronic gadgets. Because if we see 4 months back, we used to ask our students to stay away from the mobiles, stay away from the MacBooks or laptops or everything. So now, first and the foremost thing is education is happening through these electronic gadgets only. And second thing is, like, we usually go for some yoga classes in the morning, or we usually go for some physical exercises. Again, these things are also happening virtually. So what is a concern as per me is that all these things are actually adding up to their health misery. You know, there are a lot of implications. Doesn't matter you're giving some physical exercise, but it is happening virtually, which is actually affecting the physical health of a child.
No, I understand. I think the biggest factor here is to ensure that the parents are on board and they're supporting. Because, again, as you say, age varies from child to child and their understanding. But I think the parents have to be very influential in ensuring that it's sufficient. Because education is two-part. One is your theory, and one is your practical. So what we as an organization base is majority is on practical physical education, backed up with theory, but it has to be the right balance.
Right. So, okay, fine. Thank you.
No pleasure. Thank
yes,
you.
Yes, nice to meet you. We have a Gopal Arora with us, and Gopal Arora just shared a big news. We have a association with the India's number one medical university, which is Santosh Medical University. So just share your views, how we are associated with us, this big.
Thank you, Dr. Dev. Thank you for allowing me to, you know, open my mic. Are you able to hear me?
Yes, we are.
Am I audible? That would do. So Dr. Dev and myself, we've been associated for quite a long time, and it is not very regular for me to attend meetings because of other occupations relating to Spa India and other works which we have, academic, operational, finances. Recently, we tied up, we did an MOU with a leading university in India that is called Santosh University. It's present here in Ghaziabad. It has a beautiful campus, and it was only 3 days back that we inked that MOU. The MOU is, we would come in as academic partners to, you know, take care of the sports physiotherapy and medicine course. Now, given our outdoor sports, this assumes importance because, outdoor sports do have a very fair chance of, you know, people getting injured, and we have seen in our lives. So, and more so with the, if one remembers, if I just go back, take an example, that would be better. If one remembers, you know, those days when the cricket, I am fond of cricket, so I'll talk about cricket and to some extent about football. So the 50-over match used to be a low-scoring match. Typically, a team would make about 200-250 runs, somewhere in that range. And as we have progressed, a 20-over match is, one can expect the same score in a 20-over match. So what does it tell you about the physical exertion that a player has to take place, that takes place inside a player? So that is huge. I mean, consider 50 overs and a 225 runs on the board, and the same amount you are getting today in 20 overs, that 200-plus score. So which means the players are practicing more, they are exerting physically more, and beyond a point, what will happen? Things will rupture. So the physiotherapy is meant to, you know, take care of your aches, and sports medicine is meant to take care of your body health. To up your fitness to a level where you can, you know, actually address to the demanding needs of the sport. So this is the recent one, MOU with Santosh University, and we hope that we'll be able to provide the kind of necessary academic inputs, and the university will share its infrastructure and its knowledge of medicine and physiotherapy, and maybe our patrons here would help us with getting us connected to the outer world, so that, you know, students can find meaningful placements after they have spent with us. Thank you, Dr. Dev. Anything else you would like me to talk about?
Nice insight, and very soon we will go tie up for more of the university to create a economical employable program for youth of India. Why I am emphasizing of the word economical? Because as all we are aware about, more than 26 crore teen population from age of 13 to 19 in India. Out of 25 crore, only 2 crore boys and girls are able to get that flag, right to education, right to food, right to live a good life. So rest of 23 crore people, boys and girls, are still, they are far behind to get these kind of facilities. So we all together will work I think 1 lakh Britishers hold the 30 crore population of India. And why not we all 1 lakh teachers can make a career of the 25 crore youth of India. So we have to go through this, and I learned from this Pratibha ji. Then definitely now I wish to want some views from Pratibha ji. So please just share your views on it.
Very good evening to everyone. Special welcome, warm welcome to both the speakers. It was a really great session. We really came to know many things from Ludhiana to London. And sir is so basically from Ludhiana. I mean Punjab, I mean to say. So definitely your mitti is calling you. So yeah. I really appreciate being in UK. You are really working for India and representing India. It's a great honor for the Indian people too. Sir, my one suggestion to everyone here who all are present, esteemed people over here. We are having so many webinars, we are presenting so many awareness programs, and we are doing so many things. But we are doing among the educators, we are doing among the learners. We are not promoting these things among the parents, because sometimes parents need to be well aware of such things, because they are lack of knowledge. They are not having full knowledge that this sports even can be a career. Sports even has a huge difference in the career, and not only in India, abroad also. So I feel personally, how I personally involve, the other universities from abroad, they come to my school, they conduct the, and I involve parents, because that only will make a huge difference in our program and the vision, what we are looking ahead. Because see, learners, they want to become, but in the school level, if parents, they promote, if parents, they support, and if parents guide them, for the appropriate field, what the kids are looking for, and they are. I think it will really work, and then we all can work the way we are looking forward. I feel this is just my suggestion. And
no, it's right. The ultimate aim is behind, and this I shared the entire thing to the all principals, and then definitely you all people will help us, and you share that same link to everyone. We have a capacity, yes, of big capacity. Then no issue of the numbers are there. So we have other software also. We can manage everything.
Yes, sir.
Now, Dr. Bala have a...
Yes, sir. One thing. Why? Because, the Indian mentality. We feel if we talk, then it is like a ghar ki murgi dal barabar. Yes. If we talk from the mountain, then our mindset change. Ho jata hai. Perspective change. Ho jata hai. So that way I'm looking upon. See, if I'm a principal, I'm telling, so they will say, अरे school का कुछ benefit होगा इसलिए madam promote कर रही है. But वही कोई बाहर वाला आके बोलेगा तो impact powerful होता है.
So Prathamaji, if I just may intersect here, I think you picked up a very valid point, because the parents are primarily the decision makers because of for various different reasons. True. Now, as I said earlier, when we came to India and we did our delegation pretty much around India, we went into different institutions, universities, and we insisted that we want to speak to the parents because they need to be educated and understand the benefits of sports as a career. So, I mean, sports, in my view, is a crucial sector, and it provides a solution during particularly these turbulent times. Furthermore, it provides a feeling of connectivity, bringing people together locally and globally. Therefore, it's vital transition in anything that we do. And as you say, we went into international schools, and the next step was to engage with the parents as well as the children. So any questions they have, whether it's safety, whether it's will their investment into the children, how will it benefit them? And that's what we do. We provide the exposure here in the UK, and UK is a leader in the sports field globally. But as you quite rightly say, when someone from outside comes, and I think the drums, when they sound, the beat is different and the feeling is different.
True, I agree with you. I totally agree with you. Thank you so much. Thank you, sir.
Pleasure.
Dr. Bala. Yes, Dr. Bala. Open your talk.
Thank you, sir. Good evening. Yeah. And Mr. Lakhbir talked about the exposure for a sports personality at UK. And of course, he's from the land of the great stalwarts in sports, Sebastian Coe and Terry Thompson. Of course, he talked about the various openings in UK. I'm thrilled about it. But I was surprised to see snooker is playing a dominant role. Of course, as far as we know, football and cricket is the most, important sports in UK. Football, of course, and athletics too. And they have a great facilities in UK. And I say, no, most of the sports stars over there are professionals. And they are not based on any companies or any corporates, if I'm not wrong. But as Ravindra Mann told very clearly, he's running a school in rural area. So promoting those children is a tough ask for her. And of course, for which he has to convince the parents. And most of the parents over here are orthodox people. And they never permitted girl child to be in the sports. But I'm telling you, once they started tasting success, and definitely they'll come out. And I've seen from India, mostly that all the superstars are from rural belt, mainly from Haryana and Punjab, mainly in wrestling and if not in boxing. And even Pradeepa Misra echoed the same feeling. Parents need to be convinced. And it's in the hands of edu leaders. So you connect with SPA, become a sports edu leader, you can strike a balance between sports and education easily. So what I'm telling, when you're talking about total education, and it comes, sports comes under the total education. Education and sports are the two sides of the same coin. And as everyone put it rightly, and mental well-being, it based on your health also definitely. And sports, we cannot stop the children. But the way we are taking the children, even now, when the classroom decision has been declared, most of the teachers, most of the principals are very proud to announce the results about the marks oriented. There is no much difference between 496 and 490. Okay, it's in the hands of the evaluators or somebody not tested properly. It happens in the sports field too. So what I'm telling, we should throw the light on the sports, bring the children, especially as Ravindra Kaur Mann rightly told, that children from the rural area can be brought to the sports scene. And as Lakhbir sir told that, there are sponsors available definitely. But their real potential, they can prosper into a great, great strength even in other countries too. So it's not necessary they cannot come out. Look at P.T. Usha. She only studied, she's only matriculate. But now she's running a sports academy in Kerala. And it's become a breeding center for so many athletes, mainly middle distance runners. See, it's in the hands of we, the leaders, or the sports personalities to groom such great stars. I think we'll be the victors at the end of the day. I think Ms. Lakhbir Singh will agree with me, and even Ravindra Ma'am definitely will agree with me. Thank you, sir. Thank you for giving me an opportunity.
I will add two sentences, Mr. Dr. Bala. I agree even with Pratibha also. It's very difficult to make the parents to be convinced, and especially in our area. But regular there is a complaint also. Ma'am, aake dekho to sahi, bhi yahan pe ye dekho, sare ground pe khelte ja rahe hai. They are not studying. And for that, we used to have the, when they used to visit my office, oh, when they see the medals and all, then I had made separate columns that these had been won by my girls and these are from boys. And that time they feel, yes, ma'am, kahenge aap ek hi principal ho jo bolte hai shaam ko bachon ko khelne diya karo. And ma'am, baaki sab bolte hai ghar mein rakho, band karo, band karo. So it's true. To parents, it's very, very difficult to convince, and that should be also the one of the next step to be taken by all the educationists. Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you, Devinder.
So, now Kanika, just share your views, and one more announcement that on Tuesday, Dr. Bala and Kanika will come again on diet management for the sports person, not only sports person, for everyone. A special part two, which is already I got a very good request from the people. I think this thing we must share with the entire parents also, the diet for each and everyone, even then the mother and father both have to take a right diet. So Kanika, just share your views, and Baljeet Kaurji, welcome.
A very good evening to everyone. And I really appreciate the thought process of Latveer Singh ji and ma'am from Ludhiana. So it's a great journey from Ludhiana to London, because we are getting a great insight that, you know, how sports education is working from India to abroad. So, you know, one very important point which we need to work on is to convince the students and parents to play and to ensure that they adapt this as, you know, a career. So since this is a very turbulent time, we all are not going on a regular base, on regular work, on regular path. So this is a time when we can invite them towards a new venture, which is called a sports management or a sports education. The only phenomena which we can apply is, you know, if you look at the example of municipal schools, before they have not introduced the midday meals, the students were not ready to come to, you know, for education to schools. The moment government introduced the midday meals, there was like numbers turning up. So we need to come up with some ideas. We all educationists, we all intelligent minds, you know, we all need to devote some time and come up with the ideas which are convincing for people from economically background or underprivileged or from villages, because as very correctly said by ma'am, that, you know, there is a lot of talent present there, but the only thing is that we need to convince them to come to field and play. So we have to incentivize them, and what could be that incentive? We need to plan that together, where we can push our talent to fields and ensure that medals are ours, where we can convince the parents to understand that how important it is to play sports, where we can convince the parents to, you know, give them an idea that what kind of development is going to happen once the child is involved into the sports or an education related to sports. So all those things need to be planned by all of us and need to be implemented at this time only. So we can say that this has to be a very quick and, you know, emergency kind of a plan which need to be implemented quickly before we end up with this turbulence time, because this is a time when we can actually work out and make a best use of it. So we would definitely need Lagbir Singh ji and, you know, other people from you know, abroad to pitch in with us, so that, you know, these people feel that there is going to be actually an incentivized program for them to, you know, have an exposure abroad, or you know, they get an opportunity to play for different countries, or, you know, something of that sort, that we need to do a kind of a brainstorming all together. So that's what I think.
That's wonderful, wonderful. And we have a very good news for all of us, because every year we celebrate. For us, for our beloveds, and those have become a much more beloved for all of us. Then today, CEO of Mr. Chris Wetton is his birthday. So we all can open the videos and give a big clap for the happy birthday to Mr. Chris Patris. Please, everyone. Yeah, Dr. Payal Shivani, most welcome. Happy birthday to you. Everyone can open a mic also, so we can be louder. We can celebrate in the Punjabi style.
Happy birthday.
Welcome, Nitu ji.
Happy birthday, Chris.
Yes, good.
Thank you, ji.
Good to see you all. Just I am taking a one photograph. Everyone, please stay on video like this. Yeah, I am taking a photograph to share. Happy birthday. Yes. Yeah, ready. Hi, there are other people are there. So we have only. Yeah, that's fantastic. Anjana ji, good. Yes, that's great. This is the happy birthday wish for Chris. I will share a photo with you, Lakhbir ji.
Thank you, ji. Both were merbani. Happy birthday to everyone. I'm sure he will.
It's truly good. Yeah. So it's a birthday of us. Hi, Meenakshi. Good to see you. It's a new avatar again. Meenakshi, just wave your hand. Yeah. Meenakshi, you see that Meenakshi is one of the power lifter with us. That's good to see you, everyone. So, Baljeet Kaurji, would you like to share your views? Because I invited everyone who want to share their views, then most welcome. Open the video. Yes, we can have a 5 more minutes with us. So, one minute, everyone can share their views about this sports education, employability and all. Baljeet Kaurji. I think Ranjana. Ranjana, how are you?
I'm good, sir. Always happy share to your see views your with you. Jolly face. So always nice. Keeping a smile on your face. That's made my day.
So kind. Wow, that's good compliment. Thank you so much.
That gives inspiration. Yeah, your smile always gives inspiration to everyone.
Now I have a big smile of Lakhbirji also. Yeah.
Yes.
That's good.
I'm happy to hear this session. It's really wonderful session. Lakhbir sir, I really appreciate that sitting in London and still you are having love for your country. Still you are connected with Ludhiana. Really appreciable.
Yes, that's great. So anyone want to say something more? And then I wish to over to our speakers for the closing remark. So I think it's our simple rule of the online webinar. Just come on the video, then I can invite or share your views. It is a simple rule. So it's automatically, it's not written anywhere, but we feel ki those are on the video, it means he will say something, his expression and everything will come up. So over to Ravinder Kaurji for the closing remark and give the wishes to youth of entire world to keep happy and healthy and take care, must hygiene, take a healthy food which made by his own in the kitchen nowadays, not by mother and sister only.
I'm not so mother and sisters. Yeah, I will just extend my gratitude.
I'm talking about the boys.
Boys especially. Okay. No doubt, I extend my gratitude to all of you. And especially, I will say that you all should, no doubt, you're keeping your work or the time, you're giving time to everyone, even for the physical fitness. And especially if I will talk to boys, they used to have the perfect and the fit to be always and to have the one builder, bodybuilders and all have the abs. So they should keep it up and they should help their parents, mother especially. And if I will talk of the girls, no doubt they are not less than boys. They are also, I will say, the equal, and they will be also. So this is the one of the platform you have to keep in your mind that you can be even the director like the Davinder and the owner and even the event manager. You can be you can be the curriculum planner, and as Lakhvir said, the coach trainers, and they can be the physical education teachers, and even they can explore them over here. Unless and until they won't be in the sports, they won't be able to understand the business. If they want to go for the business also, they can go for the equipments or the dresses, or I will say the wears, whatever. That can be only possible when they are supposed to fit and they feel that it is required urgently. So all the youth, keep it up and be with the spider and maintain yourself and make your career in it and join it. Thank you, Davinder. And thank you, Lakhvirji, that Davinder has given very good point, Ludhiana to London. Today, we are all, I think, on the platform feeling that yes, we all are supposed to be one, and only all are having the one focus, how to make youth on the proper track. That is only the one, which is the most important, either the educationist as a parent or as a human being. So thank you, Lakhvirji, and thanks to Davinder that he has done a beautiful, and he's the one who had started, I think I know him when he was supposed to be on the first step. At that time, what the efforts he had placed, and now where he is. I know every who can, I will say, that how, what the pros and cons, what he has faced now and then. And but this shows also when you have the goal setting. Goal settings is very important. When he has the one of the person is having the goal, he has made that I have to reach over there, and he had shown it also. And even CBSE is supposed to, as being the principal of the CBSE school, they also are very much aware and aware of Davinder Arora. And it feels me so proud also that yes, he is the one who I know very well. Thank you, Davinder, to give this opportunity. So thank you.
It's all wishes. I think we have to listen to the closing remark from Lakhvirji. And as you give, all people give a wishes to my son, Mahakdev Arora. He got All India rank first.
And yes, everybody saw that.
Thank you so much, everyone.
It's a proud moment. And when you have shared that also, I had shared to others also. That's the one
fantastic.
We are supposed to.
Congrats, sir, for that.
Thank you so much. Shweta?
Yes, sir.
Aisha, how are you? Aisha is here, I think. Yeah, Lakhvirji.
Good evening, sir.
Yes. Shweta, would you like to say something? Come on video. Condition is this.
Can't come on video right now.
Yeah, come. Because everybody want a photograph with you. We can't give an autograph, we can give you a photograph. Are you coming or shall I invite to Lakhvirji?
Please sir, invite Mr. Lakhvir.
Okay. Yeah, Lakhvirji, forward to you for closing remarks.
No, thank you very much. So I'm very honored to be given this opportunity by Dr. Oraji, and on his positive note, I would like to extend our sincere congratulations to Mahek and both Bol Mubarakah Vadanya, and I wish they succeed in their journey. And moving on from that, just slightly touching on some of the points that have been made about parents and changing their mindset. I think that's something very important. And I'll be more than delighted, me and my team here in London, to support anyone on this webinar in any way, shape or form. Yonke, together as a force for good, we can work together. And here in the bilateral UK and India corridor, you know, we have to become a part of the living bridge. Like our Honourable Prime Minister Modiji, he's obviously got various different government initiatives that are taking place. We here in the UK have them. So it's time to match them up for the better. And in fairness, it all comes down to the future of the country, and that is our children. So once again, thank you very much to Ravinder Kaur Ji and Dr. Ji. And I'd be more than delighted in the future to have our CEO on his behalf. I'll extend a very thank you to everyone. And I look forward to future webinars. Thank you very much.
next time we wish to invite him as a speaker also. So now I invite Gopal Arora for a vote of thanks to our honorable speaker. Yes, Gopal ji.
Thank you, Dr. Arora, for allowing me this opportunity to thank everybody present here. Before I spell out all the names, let me first thank Dr. Pala and Lakhbir Singh ji, our speaker for today, and Rajinder Kaur ji. Am I right? Am I correct? Ravinder Kaur ji. So thank you very much for enlightening us with your wisdom, your words, and with your suggestions. It was an excellent session, and everybody had, chipped in with his or her points. And these sessions are extremely important, which help us to, understand, take the feedback, and, try to improve ourselves or try to be more meaningful to the society. So thank you. And Dr. Devendra Arora, Neetu Sharma ji, Pakhur Vedi ji, Pratibha Mishra ji, Kanika ma'am, Baljeet Kaur ji, Goldie Sehgal sahab, Likhita ji, Ranjana ji, Shweta ji, and thank you, Dr. Balachandar. Thank you, everybody. And I close this for today. Thank you, Dr. Arora. Keep organizing.
Yes, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Sayonara.
Sayonara. See you soon.
All of stay bye, safe. Stay, yeah. Safe. Yeah.
Stay safe.
Yes. That is important. Bye. Bye-bye. Take care.
Bye.
Thank you so much. Thank you, everyone.
Dr. Arora?
Yeah.
Dr. Arora, please come back online in a one-to-one meeting with me. We have some issues to discuss.
Okay. Let me do.
Okay. Okay. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you. Thank you
so much. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you so much.